Hallelujah, precious saints. Well, this very day, we're going to pray a prayer of protection. Hallelujah. So throughout the Bible, we are constantly reminded to fear not. It is not God's will that we live in anxiety or fear or even dismay. But remember, He is well able to protect you and your family and all who take a stand on His word. So we can see that prayers that are linked to Scripture will always have power. So put yourself and God in remembrance of His word and know that only we are safe or in that safe place and where we can have protection, because Scripture has many ancient prayers for protection. In actual fact, throughout most of Scripture, there is protection prayer. So during difficult times in life, many Christians turn to God and Scripture for comfort and protection. They need to seek to find peace in a tiny, in the tiny print of the Word of God. That is what we need to come to. So when you want to be reassured, we come to the Scripture. When we look at the story of Joseph, who was knocked down as far as a man can be pushed, and yet went on to be the second most powerful man in Egypt. So Christians maybe want ease of their hearts with the words of Peter, Paul, Moses, David, Solomon, and of course, Jesus Christ himself. So many Christians do manage to find comfort in the tales and most importantly in the words of the apostles and of the prophets. So we need to actively make the word of God part of our life. More than 220 prayers are written out in the Bible. So in the Old Testament, there contains 176 prayers through Scripture. And the New Testament, there are 46 prayers throughout Scripture. And this counts only the prayers that are written out word by word. As such, there are many prayers for Christians to choose from their own personal use. So not every prayer is a prayer for protection, of course, but there are many prayers that need very little tweaking to because a protection prayer. So here are seven prayers for protection in difficult times that are either directly from or based on prayers in the Scripture. So let's have a look at here. So every day that we know for the most part, but we are entering into the enemy's territory and he has set traps and snares for us to fall into. But that is why Jesus said, according to his word, in Matthew 6 verse 13, it says, God deliver us from temptation of the evil one. Or according to 1 Peter 5:8, he prayed a protection from the enemy every day when you think of it, because Satan is what? He's like a roaring lion roaming about seeking whom he may devour. So throughout the Bible, we're constantly reminded to fear not. It is not God's will that we live in anxiety or fear or any of those things. But remember, he is well able to protect us and keep us in a safe place for the appointed time. So 2 Thessalonians 3:3, it says, but the Lord is faithful and he will strengthen you and protect you from the evil one. Psalm 46:1, God is our refuge and strength and our ever-present help in trouble. And according to John 17 verse 15, my prayer is not that you take them out of the world, but that you protect them from the evil one. And according to Matthew 6 verse 13, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. And according to Psalm 16 verses 10 to 11, because you have not abandoned me to the realm of the dead, nor will you let your faithful one see decay. You make known to me the path of life, and you will fill me with the joy of your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand. So we're going to pray today and come before our Father, and we're also going to combine many scriptures amongst these prayers. So Heavenly Father, In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you that you watch over us and your word is performed as a result of your actions. Father, we praise you that we dwell in the secret place of the Most High and that we shall remain stable and fixed upon the shadow of the Almighty, whose power no foe, no enemy can withstand. And we will say to you, Lord, the Lord is our refuge and our fortress, our God. On him we lean and rely, and in him we constantly trust. For then you will deliver us from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. Then you will cover us with your feathers, and under your wings shall we trust and find refuge. Your truth and your faithfulness are our shield and buckler. Father, you are our confidence, firm and strong. You keep our foot from stumbling, being caught in the trap or hidden danger. Father, you give us safety and ease us. We know you and will keep us in perfect peace because our mind is stayed upon you and we trust in you. And we thank you, Lord, for what you are doing, and that we may lay down and you will give us a peaceful sleep, and you will sustain us and make us dwell in safety. And Lord, that we shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow or the evil plots and slanders of the wicked that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor the destruction and sudden death that surprise and lay waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at our side and 10,000 in our right hand, but it shall not come near us. Only will we be a spectator, and shall we be, and we will be inaccessible in a secret place of the Most High, as we witness the reward of the wicked, according to Psalm 91. So continue to meditate on these prayers. As you open up your heart right now, the Lord will send the Holy Spirit to fill the floodgate. We pray this prayer in the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, your one and only Son, who died and rose again for remission of sins, we bind, we rebuke, we render powerless all division, discord, disunity, strife, wrath, murder, criticism, condemnation, pride, envy, jealousy, gossip, slander, evil speaking, complaining, lying, false teaching, false gifts, false manifestation, lying signs and wonders, poverty, fear of lack, fear of spirits, deceiving spirits, religious spirits, hindering spirits, every occult spirit, witchcraft spirit, spirits of Antichrist, and all familiar and territorial spirits. We bind all curses that have been spoken against us. We bless those who curse us, and we pray blessings upon those who spitefully use us. And we bind all spoken judgments made against us and judgments that we have made against others. We bind the powers of negative words from others, and we bind and render useless all prayers not inspired by the Holy Spirit, whether psychic, soul force, witchcraft, or counterfeit tongues that has been prayed against us. Oh Lord, we are children of God, and we resist the devil and declare that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. We put on the full armor of God, Lord, our loins girded with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness and the shed should feet of the preparation of the gospel of peace, taking the shield of faith, which will be able to fire off the fiery darts of the wicked one, the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always in supplication and with the saints, hallelujah, according to Psalm 91. The Holy Spirit leads and guides us today and fills us with all needed gifting and graces, and we discern between the righteous, we discern between the righteous and the wicked, and we take authority over Satan and all his demons and those people who are influenced by them. We declare Satan is under our feet, and we shall remain there all day. Lord, we thank you that, Lord, we praise your holy name because we know that the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, Lord, we claim it, for we are God's property. Satan, you are bound from our family, our mind, our body, our home, and our finances. And we confess that we are healed and made whole, and we will flourish, and we are long-lived, we are stable, we are durable, we are incorruptible, we are fruitful, we are virtuous, we are full of peace, we are patient, and we are love. Whatever, ever, whatsoever we set our hands to do shall prosper, for God supplies all of our needs. God, we pray, Lord, for the ministry that you have for each of us. Anoint us, God, that with all that you have called us to do, you will give us the grace that is sufficient. Hallelujah. And we put them, Lord, thank you, Lord Jesus, that you will send forth your angels to surround us today and everybody, and put them and surround throughout our house and around our cars, souls, bodies, wills, and emotions. And we call on your holy angels to protect our house from all intrusion, and protect us and our families and those, Lord, that we have not named, but they are named in our hearts, and anything from any harmful demonic or physical or mental attacks. And we ask this in your mighty name, because we know that God is a great protector. His name in Hebrew to describe is Jehovah Nissi. He is the one who defends, delivers, covers, preserves, shelters, and watches over us. Sometimes we need to call upon him in our prayers for protection. So, Lord, we just cry out to you right now. According to the scripture, Jacob's prayer for protection from Esau was written in Genesis 32, verses 9 to 12. It said, "Please deliver me from the hand of my brother." And Jacob then said unto God, "O God of my father Abraham, and God of the father Isaac, O Lord, who made and who said to me, return to your country and to your kindred, that I may do you good. I am not worthy of the least of the deeds and steadfast love and all this faithfulness that you have shown to your servant. For with only my staff I crossed this Jordan, and now I have become two camps. Please deliver us from the hand of my brother and from the hand of Esau, for I fear him that he would come and attack me and the mothers with the children. But he said, I will surely do you good and make your offspring as the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered and cannot be brought to any multitude." Hallelujah. Jehoshaphat, Lord, he prayed for protection from the Moabites and the Amorites. And he said that according to 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verses 6 to 12. It says, "O Lord God of the fathers, are you not the God of heaven? You rule over all the kingdoms and the nations, and in your hand are power and might, so that none is able to withstand you. Do you not know that our God is divine, out and divide and drive out all the inhabitants of this land before your people Israel, and give it forever to the descendants of Abraham, your friend? And they have lived in it and have built for you in it a sanctuary for your name, saying, if disaster comes upon us, the sword, judgment, pestilence, and famine will stand before this house and before you, for your name is in this house." And we cry out to you today. So Ezra fasted and prayed for protection from his enemy. Then we see also, according to Ezra 8:21-23, "Then I proclaimed a fast there at the river, and that they might humble ourselves before our God to seek him from a safe journey and from ourselves and the children. For I was ashamed to ask the king for a band of horse soldiers and horsemen to protect us against the enemy, as we know that the hand of our God is for our God and will seek him, and the people of his wrath is against all who forsook him." So he fasted and implored God for this, and listened to our entreaty. Hallelujah. When God listens, he listens. Just as he listened to King Jehoshaphat, just as he listened also to David, who was praying, and also to Ezra, who was praying, God will listen to us. Now, David wrote according to the protection of his son Absalom in Psalm 03. It says, O Lord, how many are my foes? Many are rising against me. Many are saying, oh, my soul, there is no salvation for him in God, Selah. But you, O Lord, are the shield about me, my glory and the lifter of my head. I cried aloud to the Lord, and he answered me from his holy hill, Selah. I lay down and slept. I woke again, for the Lord sustained me, and I will not be afraid of many thousands of people who have set themselves against me all around. Oh, arise, O Lord, and save me, O God, for you strike all my enemies on the cheek, and you break the teeth of the wicked. Salvation belongs to you, and your blessing is to be upon your people. So, Lord, we just thank you in the name of Jesus. We thank you for Stephen, who prayed for protection and mercy, even of his murderers. And as he fell, according to Acts 7, verses 60, it says, and falling to his knees, he cried out with a loud voice, Lord, do not hold any sin against them. And when he had said this, he fell asleep. Hallelujah. So God was constantly speaking throughout the scriptures and speaking to us of God's protection. Now, based upon Psalm 140, verses 1 onwards, it says, deliver me, O Lord, from evil men. Preserve me from violent men who plan evil things against my heart. Oh Lord, guard me and help me. The arrogant have hidden a trap for me, and with cords they have kept a net beside the way that they are. Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus. But according to Ephesians 6, we put on that full armor of God today in the name of Jesus. According to Numbers 6, verse 24, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord to make his face shine upon you and gracious to you, the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Hallelujah. God's promise is always to give us peace. Psalm 71, verses 1 onwards. In you, Lord, I will take refuge. Let me never be put to shame in your righteousness. Rescue me and deliver me, and turn your ear to me and save me by my rock of refuge, to which I can always go and give the command to save you. For you are my rock and my fortress. Deliver me, my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the grasp of those who are evil and cruel. Most of the Psalms are made up of prayers, and these prayers for battle, they're prayers of praise and prayers of protection. Psalm 71 is a combination of prayers and praise and prayers of protection. The first part of the Psalm is the calling for continuing protection, and the end is a prayer of praise and triumph. So according to Psalm 71 verse 1 is purely about protection. This prayer asks for God to take up the refuge for the person praying. Well, in ancient times they will have meant of a refuge from war and death. However, this does not mean that this prayer is applicable today, is not applicable, but God has and will continue to be a refuge for many things and many people, no matter that circumstance. So Heavenly Father, we thank you in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory for what you're doing right now in the name of Jesus. Righteous Father, we ask you to help us see the enemy when he attacks, so that we can recognize when he does. We know that we fight an invisible enemy, an invisible foe who is stronger than us. And we know that we are not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against powers of darkness and rulers of evil, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers in the present age. And we understand that we are fighting against the spiritual forces in evil in the heavenly places, according to Ephesians 6 verse 12. Thank you, God, for protecting and providing the armor that we need today and every day, including the breastplate of righteousness you provide with the belt of truth, the shields of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Father, we pray today, Lord, please help us, defend us today when we enter into the enemy territory within this world. Lord, if we share the gospel with the lost, we know that we are opposing the prince of darkness and his wicked army of demons that are entering into his realm. But Jesus, we know that I and we are like a lamb amongst the wolves, according to Luke 10, verse 3. But we also know that the demons are subject to you, according to Luke 10, verse 17, that no enemy who opposes us will prevail, because we have your authority to take the gospel into the kingdom of darkness, that you have given us power over the enemy, according to Luke 10, verse 19, and that no weapon turned against us will succeed, according to Isaiah 54, verse 17, because you have defeated the enemy at the cross, and we are asking you to protect us from those who would be against us, including those under the sway of Satan, as it is for your purpose that we go today and every day to seek the lost. And we pray, Lord Jesus, that you'll give us the power that comes from the Holy Spirit and the power of authority that comes from you to be our witness into this world, according to Acts 1:8, and that you go with us. Therefore, we go today, that knowing that you are with us even until the day of the present age, according to Matthew 28, verse 20, in the sovereign King of Kings and Lord of Lords' name, Jesus Christ, we pray today even more so. And we ask, Father God, we know that your Spirit is within us, and it is greater than he that's in the world. We thank you, according to 1 John 4:4, and this enemy presently holds those who are blind and held captive, because the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel and of the glory of God, who is the image of God, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. Please help us, that Satan would not outwit us or the people we are with, or not unaware of his schemes, according to 2 Corinthians 2, verses 11. And he has surely never given up on trying to help captive those who are still in his sway, and have and may, and many cannot, but escape from the snare of the devil, according to 2 Timothy 2:26, who has held hostage the whole world, according to Revelation 12, verse 9, except those who have been set free by the Son, Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, we ask you to help us, that we will know and that we will secure our hands for the appointed time, Lord, according to John 10, verse 28 to 29, and to not fear what man or the enemy can do, for since you are with us, who could ever oppose us, according to Romans 8, verse 31. For this we thank you, dear Lord and great God, in the presence, in the name of the Lamb of God who died before us. Heavenly Father, you will come right now and shower your people with your protection, your blessing. Your Spirit will surround them as a hedge of protection, as a hedge of fire right now. You will come and fill them, touch them, renew them, and lead them into all truth, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom.